Buddha. The power of persistence. The reason why a lot of people can't get what they want because they're not persistent. Nowadays, everybody to see it on money, which ain't nothing wrong with it, but with me. Money is the title of almost everything we got. From the gas tank to the health insurance, come on somebody. Everything rising, it seems like the check is on the standstill. The gas price rising, it seems like the check is on the standstill. Come on somebody, the food price rising, it seems like the check is on the standstill. Come on somebody, the cable is rising. We know we got cable too. We weren't watching it, it's not a necessity, but we know some of us can't live without watching football and basketball and soccer and baseball and tennis. Or some people like to watch the world poker. Come on somebody, some of us like to watch the pool game. Come on somebody, the National Pool Association, or whatever TV show you like to watch, whether it's All in the Children's General Hospital, come on somebody, ER, whatever show you may have out there that you like to look at, House of Pain, come on somebody, oh come on, help the Holy Ghost. So we make sure that cable bill is paid. Sometimes we don't bring you below the sound of power, listen, make sure you still got a good cable channel, because some of we can't do without cable.
By the time you got finished, you may have a bigger background, but you sure got full. You
sugar that's running all through the roof. But mama made sugar you hate. Why? Because she gave you something that was gonna stick to you. And mama told you, and to trust in God and lean not to your own understanding. And all my ways acknowledge him, and he'll direct your path. No, she ain't know a lot of scriptures. No, she ain't know nobody Bible calling, but she trusted God on her level, and she got to see Jesus. They don't want to end up in the hand of a baton. So you gotta learn when to get a baton. See, my son's doing young, so I gotta keep myself in shape. Yeah. But sooner or later, I ain't gonna be able to shoot the basketball. Right. But if I can't shoot the basketball, at least I can draw up some plays and coach a little bit. I may have to shoot a little free throw every now and then when the age kick in. But I still gotta do what I gotta do to assist him. Why? Because this is a persistent journey. And if we wanna win some of the battles over Satan, come on, somebody. You can't whip it with Oprah Winfrey. No, you gotta have some scripture in your heart. David said in 1 Psalm 119:11, thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. You better learn how to put the Bible in your heart instead of on your back. But a lot of us, we stay in witness protection too long. Yeah. We don't want to talk to nobody about Jesus except for people in the family. But we got some co-workers that need to hear a little something about Jesus. Right. Not only they can't do it on the job, but you can catch them in the parking lot. That's legal time now. Yeah. Or you got to say, I can't get fired for this one because we're in the parking lot. But the Lord pressed upon my heart to tell you that you need to come to church. You may not know a lot of scripture. You may not have a prayer life. But if you get to start coming to church, sooner or later you'll be fed the word of God. Sooner or later you'll be inspired by the word of God to read the word of God. Then you'll fall in love with the word of God. But I'm not just going to shove a Bible in your face and tell you don't get it and do what you know how to do. No, we have to be trained. And that's why some people in the church, they don't want to be trained no more, pastor. They just want to come in and do what they want to do, grab a title, give them a dog, and they ain't ready to be a usher.
They come in, they think just because they got a big offer and they make plenty of money and they get a retirement check and they got another check and a social security check and a government check and a military check. They think all the checks don't make a difference. But I come out here to tell you, you better learn how to put him in check.
And she asked for justice. Yes, yes. And the Bible said in the 6th verse, then the Lord said, hear,
what the unjust judge said. And shall God not avenge his own elect who cried day and night? In other words, he said, look at, if you look at the just, unjust judge, imagine what I do for you. See, if we learn how to do a transformational trust, in other words, taking trust out of my own ability, out of my own might, and out of my own mind, but putting my transferable trust, which means I'm taking that trust and putting it in the Lord. If we learn how to take that out of our own hands and put it in his hands, he'll work it out. Because the Bible says, in my hands shall no man pluck you out.
Yeah.
And when we get in the Lord's hands, that thing that seems like it's going haywire, that problem child, that dyslexic child, or ADHD, whatever title we want to throw in it now. Because the world want to medicate all our children, and they want to be able to discipline them. They want to be able to build, they now they're building people institutions to the dropout rate to the school. They're trying to build jails, and they got private prisons now that's in set up for our young men that's coming up in the future. And every time a mother birth a baby, they put another bunk bed in these private prisons, and they got a way that they trying to meet this number, and they want to keep this prison occupied with 7% occupants, and they want to have these jail cells built. Why? Because Satan is trying to destroy our generation, not just the young generation, not just the middle generation, but he's trying to destroy the whole bloodline. That's why he's trying to take grandma with high blood pressure and diabetes. But our grandma, she's anchored and rooted in Jesus. She knows how to pray. She knows how to get on her knees. Because she's persistent like this widow. And she say, in the name of Jesus, diabetes, you're not going to take me out. High blood pressure, you're going to come out of the authority of Jesus Christ. That's why mama 8 years old and still moving. Her mind is still sharp. She's been fighting with cancer and all sorts of things, but she just got stubborn tenacity of faith. She refused to give up. She refused to quit. She refused to throw in the towel. When it seemed like her senior years is kicking in, she get back in the kitchen to start cooking. And she said, out the riders, you may be bothering me if I need. I'll put an ice and hour. Whatever I gotta put on it, wrap it up, bring a wheelchair. For my babies.
Hallelujah.
The power of persistence. Persistence is a powerful key to deliverance. When we lose patience, we lose hope and act recklessly. That's why you can't lose patience and you can't lose hope. Because when you lose both of the cousins, both of the brothers, you begin to act recklessly. And that's why a lot of people's lives begin to decline.
Yeah.
Because they ain't patient with the Lord.
That's right.
But the Lord was patient with you.
Come on, y'all.
Come on, somebody. We need you, God. God chose us.
Come on,
y'all. The Bible said, why were we yet sinners? Christ died for us.
Yeah.
He chose us. He chose each and every one of us. That's why I tell people all the time, whatever you do in the church, I don't care if you're just a pew member. That's a blessing to be a pew member. If you're just a water person, it's a blessing that God chose you to be a water person. Why? Because you got the spirit of humility. See, everybody can't do everything in the church. That's why we got different offices like hospitality committee. Because some folks just don't have no hospitality pastor. You come over their house and they tell you to make yourself at home, but they don't want you to take your shoes off, don't want you to take your car off, but you told me to make myself at home. Look at your money for going to the refrigerator. You just told me, how are your mind? But we got to be willing workers in the
kingdom.
We got to be able to roll up our sleeves and give them the dirty and come on somebody. Because I come out here to tell you, if you want to move forward, you got to have enough faith and relentless faith. Just like the woman did in Luke 8, the woman, she kept talking to herself. And grieving when she said, if I'm not able to touch, that means she kept talking to herself. So you got to keep talking to yourself. The one with the issue of blood, she said, if I'm just not able just to touch the hem of his garment. No, I ain't been to nobody Bible study. No, I ain't been to nobody Sunday school. No, I ain't been to YPW, no vacation Bible school. No, I ain't been.